Hey guys, welcome back. OnePlus have finally started rolling out stable version of Android 10 for OnePlus 5 and 5T devices. Right now, download links are available based on Hydrogen OS. Within a day or two, we'll also receive update based on Oxygen OS. Previously, we received 3 open beta based on Hydrogen OS and Oxygen OS with a taste of Android 10. Right now, this is my OnePlus 5 which is running on the stable version of Oxygen OS which is 9.0.11. Download links of Hydrogen OS can be found in the description below which is the stable version of Android 10. Download that file and place it inside internal storage. So here you can see, here we have the file which is based on Hydrogen OS stable Android 10. After you have placed it inside the internal storage, go to settings, system update, tap on the gear icon towards the right top corner, select local upgrade and choose the file. Make sure to take a backup of your device before installing this, and also make sure your device is charged more than 30%. Tap on upgrade. Now your device will boot into recovery and perform installation process. A device has been successfully booted up. Initial boot up might take around 4 to 5 minutes. And it's always recommended to do a factory reset if there's a complete Android version change. So if you install Hydrogen OS for the first time, you'll see lots of Chinese bloatwares that can be uninstalled by long pressing and tapping on uninstall. Now let me show you the software information. About section, here you can see device is OnePlus 5, Hydrogen OS version is 10.0. Under Android version is 10. And now we have the security patch of 5th April 2020 and the build date is 13th May 2020. In this video, we won't be covering all the features because we have already covered with previous open betas. With the stable version of Hydrogen OS, launcher version is 4.1.6. This is your new recents panel. With Hydrogen OS, we get the courier tracking service in the shelf section. Alert slider is working fine. There are no issues with the alert slider. Talking about camera, there are no major improvements done with the camera. Here version is 3.0.66 and this version lacks electronic image stabilization, which will be included in future updates. All the applications like screen recorder and Zen mode are up to date. On the beta versions, most of you have been reporting about UPI services, but I have personally tested here and UPI services works fine. This will be our app drawer. Let's go inside the settings under Wi-Fi and internet. Here both the bands of Wi-Fi are working fine, 5 GHz and 2.4 GHz. Under SIM and network, Wi-Fi calling feature is not available right now and I am using my Jio SIM card. If you guys are using SIM cards like Airtel and Vodafone, let me know in the comment section below whether Wi-Fi calling feature is working or not. With Android 10, we also get a new feature of OnePlus Roaming, where you can purchase a data plan and enjoy fast data services across the different countries. Under display, we don't have any kind of issues related to adaptive brightness. Video enhancer mode works fine. Under ambient display, now we have a new feature of contextual info, which will show music info and upcoming events. And there are no issues with the ambient display. With Android 10, now we get a dedicated settings for customization, where you can customize the clock style, change essence color, change tone, and you can also change the shape of icon and shape of quick setting tiles. Under buttons and settings, we have the same stuff where you can customize the alert slider, enable or disable the backlight of buttons, swap buttons, and you can also enable the on-screen navigation bar. Talking about security and lock screen, here we don't find any kind of delay with the fingerprint scanner and face unlock. Battery backup, I'll be updating you guys after the first cycle. Along with Android 10, we also get a new feature of Cloud Sync, where you can sync your data like notes and photos. If you're using OnePlus 5T, then you should also receive the full screen gestures. That's only for OnePlus 5T, not for OnePlus 5, as we have the hardware keys available on the device. So guys, this was a quick look on Hydrogen OS stable version based on Android 10. Now let's take a look at the benchmark results using Geekbench application and AnTuTu Bench application. With Geekbench application, single core have scored 389 and multi-core have scored 1596. With AnTuTu benchmark application, device have scored 227,841. So guys, that was all about the stable Hydrogen OS based on Android 10 for OnePlus 5 and 5T. We'll soon make a video once I get the download links of Oxygen OS stable version based on Android 10. As of now, only this much in this video. Hope you guys like the video. If you like the video, then do give me a thumbs up. Also, if you're new to my channel, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.